Hey everyone, welcome to Judging for the Win. I'm Dave, and this is my daily ruling. Amy controls Darkest Hour, and she plays a Ghostflame Sliver. What color or colors is Ghostflame Sliver when it's on the battlefield? Okay, so this is a pretty straightforward continuous effects question. Before we start, though, I want to observe that Ghostflame Sliver's ability only applies while it's on the battlefield. The same is true for Darkest Hour. It only applies to creatures that are on the battlefield. Therefore, the Ghostflame Sliver spell is red and black, exactly what you would expect from looking at its mana cost, so you could counter it with a blue elemental blast or a null elemental blast, but not a ceremonious rejection, for example. Now, once the Ghostflame Sliver is on the battlefield, that's obviously going to be a different story. There will be two continuous effects that want to change its color. Now, another thing that I want to point out is that neither of these effects says that the affected permanents get to keep their original colors. This means that they will overwrite any existing colors those permanents may have had when they apply. This is exactly the same as how effects that modify card types and subtypes work, but it seems that for a lot of people, it's less intuitively obvious that color-changing effects would work the same way, maybe because this doesn't come up as often. Now, because both of these effects are color-changing, they will both apply in Layer 5, and they'll apply in timestamp order. In other words, the order that they started to apply is going to determine which one gets to apply first. So that would mean that the Darkest Hour will apply first and make all creatures black, and then after that, the Ghostflame Sliver will make all slivers colorless. So that's the answer to the original question. Ghostflame Sliver would be colorless, as would any other slivers in play. Let's now consider what would happen if Amy controlled a Darkest Hour and she played a Vestige of Emrakul. What color or colors would that be? Well, at first you might think that it should be exactly the same as the previous case, but of course there's a catch. It turns out that the Vestige of Emrakul making itself colorless is actually handled completely differently from the Ghostflame Sliver, because Devoid is a characteristic-defining ability. Now, usually I would just flash the CR definition up here where it states that Devoid is a characteristic-defining ability and call that good enough, but today let's carefully go through all the characteristics this time just for fun. The reason that CDAs exist at all, in other words, the reason why they have special handling in the rules, is because they aren't really supposed to be abilities at all. They're supposed to represent stuff that's defined elsewhere on the card, but we needed to explain it in the text box because the normal spot doesn't have enough space. And as we're going through, think about how all of the required attributes of CDAs fit in with this intuitive definition. First, a CDA defines an object's colors, subtypes, power, or toughness. Well, we're definitely good there. It's printed on the card that it affects. Yep, we're good there too. It does not directly affect the characteristics of any other objects. See, this is why Ghostflame Sliver doesn't count. It doesn't explain this super clearly in the CR, but it doesn't matter whether or not there are any other slivers in play. An ability either is or is not a CDA. The fact that Ghostflame Sliver could affect the characteristics of other objects disqualifies this ability from counting. It is not an ability that an object grants to itself. A lot of people get confused about what this means. This is what stops Mithrealized power and toughness setting ability, for example, from counting as a CDA. And finally, it doesn't set the characteristics only if certain conditions are met. So, for instance, Rusted Relic's ability is not a CDA, even though it meets all the other requirements. Alright, so Devoid is a CDA. What's the big deal? Well, as I mentioned before, CDAs get special handling in the rules because they aren't really conceptually supposed to be abilities at all. Because they represent information that's supposed to be part of a card's base stats, CDAs apply first in each continuous effects layer. Therefore, the answer is exactly the opposite of what you might have expected if you just applied the same reasoning from the Ghostflame Sliver example. The Vestige of Emrakul's Devoid ability applies first, making it colorless, and then the Darkest Hour applies, making it black. Okay, now before I close out, there's actually one more difference related to another point that I brought up during the discussion of the Ghostflame Sliver example. Also, as a result of CDAs representing what a card's base stats are, they apply in every game zone, not just the battlefield. They even apply outside the game. This means that a Vestige of Emrakul spell on the stack is considered to be colorless, meaning you could counter it with a ceremonious rejection, but not a blue blast. Again, the exact opposite of what you might have expected based on the previous example. And that's all I have for you today. How did you do? Join me again next time for another daily ruling. Until then, I hope you have a great day.